on? Yeah. Yes? Okay, clap, take my gun. So we're going up to see Jane Seymour on the Dr. Quinn set, which I'm really excited about. She's in production. And I'm just going to tell you where she got the name from, one of her quotes from her book called, what's her book called?
Jane Seymour's Guide to Romantic Living.
Guide to Romantic Living. I took the name Jane Seymour because nobody considered my real name, Joyce Penelope Wilhelmina Frankenberg, to be precise, balletic enough. They said, not without accuracy, that it could be confused with Frankenstein, Frankfurter, and Frankenberger. Romance is an attitude, a state of mind. Like all the best qualities, it comes from within. She likes to light a scented candle. Smells are so important in a romance, don't you think, Clive? Oh, we've got in a hole. What a timely thing for us. Oh, she, listen, this is good. I actually believe in an emergency kit. Candles, a bottle of fizzy wine or champagne, and some lumpfish roe. Always keep it available to make an occasion out of an ordinary day. Well, I'm gonna, you got any lumpfish on you? Come on, you're hiding some lumpfish. You got, come on, you always got a stick of lumpfish. There's two here.
Here we are, on set.
So what's the deal? Am I gonna be in Dr. Quinn?
I should think so.
Wow, wow.
I know.
How's that look, Jack?
Let me see what it looks like.
Hi!
Jane
Seymour! Yay!
Yay! You're much better dressed
than
me.
No, I'm getting into cowgirl stuff. I don't want you upstage me. What'd you do? Did you just skin some cattle this morning?
Yeah, I think so. Someone's
flat. We've all come to see just how flat this is. Now we can go home.
Oh,
end
okay.
of interview. That's unbelievable. And hard. Oh, you're wearing a little thingy there.
No. This is the
That's
me.
All you?
Yes.
Very good.
We have legs too.
Let's see those legs.
I always we've got thermals on today.
Wow, you are a red hot thing there.
You're a little red hot underneath.
So are you going to let me talk to you throughout the day to get tips, to get interpersonal things?
Everything. You just got to let me get through this really, really depressing
quiet. What's happening?
I'm going to talk to Johnny Cash about dying and, you know, dealing with death.
It's a comedy thing.
It's a comedy.
Right, okay. So go do some acting. Okay. Do what you're paid for. This is right. What's the long fingernail for? Are you into like a weird cult?
No, I just don't bother to cut that one.
Hey, you are a wild guy. Do you look like this in real life?
As a matter of fact, I do.
Do you? Because I thought you'd be more like a kind of dusky dame.
Believe it or not.
You're a guy.
A Harley Davidson model.
Why am I surprised?
I'm in the current catalog.
Really?
Yeah, I'm
what
a centerfold.
Are you posing with like something big and steely there?
No, I'm the sportswear.
Sportswear? Like undies for motorcycle guys?
No.
What are you gonna wear?
I'm gonna wear cow stuff.
Please don't go over the top.
I'm not going over the top. Clive, I'm going hooker. Is that okay? What do you think?
Well, we call them saloon girls.
Saloon girls, okay.
Okay, what do you think about this one or maybe this purple one?
I like the senorita one myself.
Yeah, the one with the flowers on
it. Because
it
shows that I have Spanish influence.
Yeah,
I've been, I've had like a big, horrible sexual thing happen to me in Mexico.
Uh-oh.
And then I've come over the border for revenge. That's my character today.
And then we'll take it to a dressing room. Is there one around here, Yvonne?
I use a toilet. Yeah. That's what they make me use on my show. How are we doing?
You look fabulous.
It's good. I just want you to see different stages.
Okay.
We're now trying to get some of my my baby fat, as we call it in the biz, into the actual bosoms. She's going to hoik him up. She's got a special piece of equipment. They're going to get a horse and a hook and then yoik him. What do you think of the name Puss? Does that sound authentic? Puss or Kitty?
Kitty.
Gussie.
Dang, you done me wrong, Johnny. You done me real wrong.
I got some sores. I want some answers to.
That's good. Now I guess hair, huh?
Yep. Hair. Okay. We got hair. We got tits. We got shoes.
Okay.
I want to look like I've just been had.
This is as trampy as I've ever done.
I got to go in here. They desperately need.
Can we make up with you or no?
Mascara on the prairie.
Oh, yeah. Now we know it's fake, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
Not just natural woman, I think.
No.
She comes out with all this just be natural, just be yourself, and I'm seeing it ladled on there, that makeup.
Ladled.
Sometimes we'll wash her face and go, why do we use anything at all? Truthfully.
We don't wear that much makeup.
Nah.
You just have to fill in the holes and wipe out the zits, right?
Shovel it on.
Here we go, guys.
72 apple.
Yeah, it's real tight, Jane.
Who do you play in this show?
Just a townsperson.
A townsperson? That's a fabulous role. Hmm? I wanted to play townsperson. You got the role. What'd you do to get that part? Would you sleep?
We had to sleep with the director.
What were you a townsperson to? Are you
I left over from Bonanza.
Yes. You weren't a Bonanza.
I gave you a dance hall girl for 14 years.
You were a dance hall? Oh, I could get tips. You were a dance hall. Seriously, you were. Were you
into my eyes?
Oh, now I recognize you.
Now I recognize you. We're going back 30 years.
But you were a dance hall
That's
girl.
Right.
What was your name?
Martha.
On Bonanza it was?
You were going back. They used my real name because it's an old fashioned.
Did you have lines or did you just show your pants?
I have lines all the time.
Did they use you? I mean, did you
all have sex
with Horace or Little Joe?
Little Joe.
You had it with Little Joe.
And Lauren.
Oh, you had Lauren? A father and son thing.
And cut.
If I really wanted a part on this show, who would I have to befriend?
Who would you have to befriend?
Who's
well,
who's
it depends on whether you wanted to speak or not speak.
I'm happy to not speak.
I don't think you would be happy not speaking. Listen
I
to
do
you
today. Know. I think you like to talk a lot. What's your name?
Robert.
You have been a fan of this interview. Seriously, I've never interviewed anybody who picked up poop. Have I? Have you talked to Jane about your job at all?
She knows what we do.
Right. And does she ever personally come and say thanks for picking up the shit on the show?
Yeah, she does. She's real thankful.
See, you get Christmas. She should be thankful, otherwise her heels would be this wadded off. Are you going to go on to doing other shows like Friends and picking up their manure? Everybody says you were a ballet dancer, and I don't believe this. I need to see the legs.
A ballet dancer? Of course I was a ballet dancer.
In the thing. How high up can you get the leg now?
Can I get the leg
yeah.
now? Okay.
It's a little proof here of the ballet
work.
What
are we going to do?
I could get my leg up pretty high too, Jane.
on the wheel?
Yep, get the...
On the wheel?
Yep.
I don't know which one goes up higher.
Wow,
that one goes...
look at that turnout.
Here you go, Ruby. Oh, that's
okay,
easy.
Okay, babe, yeah.
Okay, not playing.
All right, yeah, I'm playing. I'm still with you, Jane. Okay, battle of the legs.
What color are your pants?
Now, the only other thing, I got my bloomers on. Did
oh,
you
I
see
didn't
that?
Have bloomers.
Look at how gorgeous I am here. What else can you do?
How many kids have you got?
Three? And my cesarean scar is down by my knees now.
And this is your horse, that's mine.
Whoops. No, I like when they put their tongue in my ear.
This was
I like big tongues in my ear. No, I like that. Look, I'm slightly excited now. All right, I'll get on this one. Have I ridden?
Yes.
Do I? Well, look at how I... Look at my seat.
I know. Look at that.
Look at my seat. Have I ridden? Come on. We're going to just gallop into the hills, Jane.
Up into the hills?
And kill some muskrat. Can somebody pick my stirrups up? I'm a little, like, hanging here.
Thank you.
Jane, stirrup problems.
You ever see the Marlboro ads? You know, from Marlboro? Do you ever smoke cigarettes?
Yeah.
This is the guy who used to sell them.
Get out of here.
He's the original
Marlboro man.
He was on the poster?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah. I'm embarrassing you.
You were the Marlboro guy? What happened to you? Look what those cigarettes did, my God.
Yeah.
It's a good ad. He is today.
Yeah, right.
You know what we were reading on the way up here? Just tell me if you hated every minute of this. That romance book.
Oh.
Is that going to haunt you to the grave?
Possibly, but parts of it, I think, are...
Which parts do you still live by?
Oh, quite a lot of it.
Like what?
I think you know, if I... want to try something and I believe it's something I'm interested in trying to do, I don't stop myself from trying. And last year it was fly fishing and this year it's golf and
you wild
I'm
woman,
painting.
You.
I'm painting now. It's oil paints.
What about the
weekend.
Stuff like this I love that we were reading on the way up here, that you gave your husband the emergency pack and you put some bubbly in the thing and then also some lumpfish.
Yes, lumpfish roe. Well, of course, in those days, we couldn't afford caviar,
right.
Could you, dear? So.
Come on, ride with me.
I'll ride with you, yes.
You light candles, though, and take a bath, don't you? I'm desperate now.
I do that, too.
Please say you did
I'm
that.
Really
I read
sorry.
The book.
There are candles. There's candles
our horses.
At home, bathtubs, live by the ocean. It's very nice. I grow English roses.
Do you?
I grow English roses. On weekends, I cut them, and if I have time, I paint them.
The live roses?
The live roses, yes.
You paint them?
I paint,
what
yes.
color? Oh, you paint them. I thought you painted the roses. I thought we found a sickness. Anyway.
Your horse is trying to eat my horse.
I know, they're necking. I think our horses are bonding.
I need an
faster in my shot.
Oh, please.
Okay, here we go.
Please let me be an extra.
Okay, you have to go over there, though.
All right.
And on background, she'll walk right in front of Brian, right? Okay?
What, just tell me, should I take some feathers down?
Yeah.
No, you're
really?
Fine.
Okay, because I said I wasn't really in period. I hate that expression. So what do I do?
Here, come over here.
You are making all my day, James. Okay. I may
you guys have to move away, though. Just wait a second.
I'm going to put out, I think, for this guy.
Look, excuse me.
But
my wife's right over there.
It's okay. How do you get a part in this thing?
So, Sean, show her where this lady, where you start. Right there.
Where?
Right there.
Just, where he is.
Yeah, he's going to walk that way, and you walk that way. Camera will see you as you walk right through the
shot. Okay. Don't show my eyes.
Don't camp it up.
I won't. I'll be really
please
normal.
Be cool.
I understand.
Okay. This is for real.
No lines, though.
Lots of money. Okay.
All right, here we go now.
Here we go.
Rolling.
Rolling. Whoa.
Rolling. Here, you have a tail here.
What's that?
Your microphone.
All right. I'll have
you sing. It's not a period tail. Okay?
Nothing's period on me, babe.
Okay.
All right. I'm ready.
Okay.
B camera mark. All right, set and background. Action.
Was that good? I was in character. How was I?
It was great.
Okay.
It was great.
But just as a director, what notes could you give me if I'm ever doing it again? Sashaying from the Betty Ford Clinic.
Yeah, I think your motivation was right. You're a recovering alcoholic who's got the jitters, the shakes. Anybody who moves on the street, you're looking for. You're even attracted to horses.
Did you see that?
I saw you.
I eyed down that horse.
I saw you.
I wanted to show that we had a relationship.
You said, hello, long face.
And he was excited by me.
Oh, he was.
You're going to blow up a bit with me, aren't you? Get rid of James. Your husband is the sexiest man I've met in a long time.
He is. Why? What's
he wants James? Me. Don't tell him. He wants me.
He wants you.
Yeah.
We can't have you.
James is going to leave you and go with me. Okay?
Oh,
we love each other very much.
Is he taking the twins?
What? No, he's not. He said, you're taking the children. We're starting a whole new family.
Oh, okay.
A whole new life.
Put her in my movie.
Yeah.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Did you not see I was in it?
I did.
I was Kitty.
She stayed in it?
What do you mean she stayed in it? I was fantastic. I think your situation is a little shaky, but I was in three takes.
You'll be out of the show soon.
There we get it.
There
we have
that's
it.
Right.
Let's put our cards on the table.
Bye,
Janie.
You're going to have to be in this movie now.
Bye-bye.
You're going to have to come back.
He's mine now.
Okay.
Martha, how do you think I did?
I thought you were fantastic.
Did you get what I was
gonna
doing?
You're going to be a star.
Yes. Did you see the potential?
Yes.
I'm getting a kind of a good vibe here. You're not going to badmouth me when I'm gone.
Oh, absolutely not.
We're going to go to England just to see this show.
We're going to get a cassette over here so we can screen it for
you. You're never going to see a cassette of this, never.
But boy, is she bitchy.
She says she has a TV program there. I don't believe it.
I wonder what kind it is.
Do
you think it's one of those pornos that they show?
Probably.
How much are they getting for pornos over in England?
They haven't offered me a part.
Lisa Kudrow, do you know Kudrow? Nothing. No. Kudrow mean anything? Sir, excuse me. Kudrow, no.
Huh?
Lisa Kudrow. No, not Harum. Kudrow.
No, she's not.
No. Okay, well, shut up anyway. Our guest today is Lisa Kudrow?
Kudrow?
From Friends. You know that show?
Just
say you know the show. Okay, you know the show. Everybody's thin, they have clean hair. There's no cellulite.
Wait, that,
I hate that show. Anyway, Kudrow, when she comes up, act happy.
It's a fish.
It's a fish.
Is
it a fish?
Is she coming up?
It's so funny we're doing this because I'm not a big, like, tourist fan thing.
You're not.
No, but
you told me she wanted to tour.
It's all right.
You told me she wanted to tour.
It's okay, it's okay.
I thought if somebody came to London, they'd want a tour.
She doesn't want a tour.
No, I don't mind seeing things, but I didn't realize it's
that we're going
awkward.
To these places?
Well, no, but it's cold.
It's a little cold. This is summer in London.
No, I should have a good attitude.
Is that you would only do the interview if you came to London? And I'm not angry, but we had to pay for that. if I'm not mistaken, and the hotel accommodation. That was what, I don't know, maybe that wasn't you.
Whoa.
Okay, she's gonna be snappy.
I don't know, I pictured everything to look...
clean?
It's pretty, it's cleaner than I thought it would be. I thought it would look a little more, like genuinely historical. It looks like everything's been redone.
You mean thatched?
Well, no, not thatched. Thatched, uh-huh. I really thought that I would see dead bodies with lesions on it.
And the bell's ringing. Bring out your dead.
Hey, look where we are.
Oh, we're at Trafalgar Square.
This is Europe.
This is not fun. Is this the Queen's idea of revenge? Oh, no, don't. Is there one on me? Clive, is there one on me? Get it. If it shits on me, I'm going to sue it.
You know, this is not as much fun as it looks like.
Oh, God, there's another one. Get him off. Get him off. This is like, what's her name? Tiffy. Before her eyes got pecked out. All right, just sing while this bird shits on me. Go ahead.
Can I tell you the truth? I don't play guitar.
Oh, we'll put in the guitar.
Smelly cat, smelly cat. What are they feeding you?
That's nice. You can see why people hate pigeons. Well, there was a lot of pigeon action, big pigeon action. Yeah. So, you know, they were throwing coins, but the pigeons were blocking it. There was no money. No, but it was a really good rendition, considering you
I've
didn't know
better.
How to play guitar.
No, I've done it
do you
better.
Have a guitar, like a body double, a guitar stand-in?
No,
when you do
I do it, but I get to practice before I do it. I didn't get to practice. I usually get to practice before I play.
Didn't I tell you last week we were going to do this?
No, I didn't
and
know.
And I sent you the artificial pigeons?
No, I didn't know.
I told you we were doing this.
We're getting out now?
The changing of the guards.
Quick, they're changing.
Or they're coming in.
Now we have to run.
Yeah, now you have to run. Quick. Did we miss them?
Oh, shoot.
See, because you were dawdling on the bus. Have you ever seen Friends? He must have seen it. Do some of your lines. Do some of your lines. She plays Phoebe. It's very funny.
I wish I could, but I don't want to.
He knows the lines. He'll love you in a minute. He's just pretending to be like that. Do you know who she is, sir? Do you recognize her?
See,
if you just, one flick of the eye, and you'd be asking for an autograph. And she's really sexy in real life. That's the other thing. I read that in People. They said that about you. In real life, you're really sexy. Look at this. Look, he likes us. He's very excited. Look, he says, I like your show, Miss Phoebe. I watch it every Friday night or Thursday night if you're in America. Oh, it's a Bobby. He's a Bobby. You want to meet a Bobby, don't you?
Phoebe, how you doing?
All right, how are you? They know me. How are you?
Hi, Phoebe.
Oh, you know her.
Excellent show. How are you doing?
Excited to meet her.
That's lovely.
Do you watch her show?
I do. It's a good show.
Oh, well, there you go.
Thank you. Good show.
Who's your favorite of all the... do you think she's the most attractive of all the women on the show?
In terms of Jennifer
in the top three.
In the top three.
Jennifer. Doesn't that hurt? Aren't you wounded? Okay, now I have to do therapy with her on the bus. You've wounded her.
Thanks for your honesty.
Goodbye.
She's still depressed.
My God, but just to be told to your face.
That you're third best.
He said that.
He said it, I know.
You're in the top third. Oh, he was so witty.
You could have smacked him. Now you see it's too late. I think work it out of your system when you're there.
Oh, my God.
It's bad.
You think he meant the boys, too?
No, I don't think he meant
the
boys.
Top three out of the six?
No, we're spiraling now. No, I think he did find you attractive, but he was shy. Don't you think men are intimidated?
I think he's gay.
He's a homosexual. There's no question. I knew that right away.
That's why...
What's that?
Me?
Homo.
No, you're not a homosexual.
But it's all right if you are.
It's okay, it's not a bad thing. You can be homosexual in, you come from Japan?
Japan. Yeah, in Japan, yes.
Are there homosexuals in Japan? Are there homosexuals?
Some.
So, how many out of, let's say, a population of, I don't know, how many are there? Anyone you know a homosexual? Four homosexuals in Japan. Well, there you get information on my show and interview. Any lesbians? Yes, you are the lesbian of Japan. That's nice to meet you. Hello.
That's interesting.
Halen is less. Yes.
Less? Yeah, less fish.
Just before we start, start, you know, a lot of people, well, they've written me, have really missed the point of the show, which I think is quite difficult. So I'm just going to clear it up for us once and for all. Now, the idea is that I go to the celebrity, do you understand, wherever they may be. So give me the man. So, for example, open the fridge. Thank you. So, for example, all right, let's say I'm here, and let's say, like, Liz Taylor is in Lima, Peru, having a pedicure. I go to her. Do you understand? I go to her. Or if, like Demi Moore's having her head shaved in Caracas. Where's Caracas, Clive?
Caracas is down here. That's right.
If Demi's down there having the old head shaved, I will go to her. If Liz doesn't want me to see her having a pedicure, then I don't go to her. Do you understand? I do not go to Liz, but I go to them. I think you cleared that up. Okay. So I'm here in London's East End.
Hi, darling.
Hello, hi.
Welcome to London.
Could you just move, because I'm doing my intro?
Certainly not.
All right. I'm
a Chaucer bull.
It's a Cockney person. So I'm waiting here in the East End for John Goodman of Rosanne fame and many other films. And I don't know, why is he here? He's in London because he must be on the run from something very big in America. He's making a movie here. And I said to John, I called him, I said, John, where would you like to meet? You want to go to Buckingham Palace? You want to go to Hampton Court? Something classy. You want to go to the Houses of Parliament? He said, no, the man wants to drink. So I said, well, that's perfect. We're in England. It's just like a big trough of beer with a couple of trees on it. So we couldn't be in a better area.
So we're going to go into the old rub-a-dub, meaning pub, for a tiddlywink drink for a pig's ear. Pig's ear. All right, mate. Hi, John. Can you do this, Cockney?
Yeah.
I heard you're very good at it.
Yeah.
Could you give us just a
sugar and spice, everything nice.
No, do the accent.
Yes, this is from the Dick Van Dyke School of
Dykery.
Dykery and accents. And ear, governor. You guys correct me on this.
All right, yeah.
Ear, governor.
Don't
how the L R U. Did I fooled you?
Jack, is that good?
Don't give up the day job.
But up your Khyber does mean what I think it means.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a beautiful, that's poetry.
That's beauty. Yeah.
Wow. Thanks, mate.
All right, you cock. You can say that here. You don't get arrested. Isn't it liberating?
Thank you.
Cock, go
Mr.
on, say
Mr. That. Cock.
Were you a loser or a winner?
Oh, I was a loser.
I was still a loser.
Was.
We can feel each other out in rooms, can't we? Yeah,
well, we can feel it.
No, I know. I can always smell another one. Yeah. And you never get over it, do you?
No, you never do. You carry that to the bitter end.
I mean, right up to the Oscar winning, I guess.
I mean, there's always the feeling of getting away with something more than...
Yeah, yeah, like you're going to get busted every moment.
But I think I got enough socked away now that I don't care anymore.
Well, does money make up for it?
Yeah.
Doesn't that just throw you completely about being... I mean, I know it's a great gig to be an actor, but, like, the fact that fame is so latched onto the back end of it. What's the freakiest thing?
In lovey speak.
In lovey speak, what's the freakiest?
Fame's the worst thing that's ever happened to me.
Seriously?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to... I won't draw it out. It's just not nice.
It's eerie that people look at you?
No, I never bargained on it. And it's, you know, I made my bed, so now it's time to lie in it. So there you go.
Aren't you then amazed when you're suddenly working with me or Al Pacino?
I mean, things happen in gradual stages, and by the time I'd worked with Mr. Pacino, I was, God, he was so damned happy to be working with me. No.
No, you know, because some people
we're doing a scene. Al, you got the best eyes. I'm sorry, did I say that in the middle of a take? Cut. Anyway.
It was a stupid question. Punish me.
Where's the perp? Al, you were so goddamn good in The Godfather, man. Cut. I'm sorry. I won't do it again.
The only other thing I got to ask you about is, obviously, because in this country, we get Rosanne here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You get her? Because I never have, and I've been working with her for 8 years.
I just want to know, did you have to sleep with her to get the part? Just clear it out. Just
get
it out.
Slept, ate,
everything.
Drank, you know,
poured Bosco down her front.
Yeah.
Licked it off.
And Bosco's still pretty pissed off. What I like to do is try to make her laugh until she pees her pants. That's my goal in life.
Yeah.
And when I get her, I know.
Because you hear the flies buzzing.
Yeah. No, it's just...
I gotta go.
How much do you get paid on Roseanne? Just, you don't have to tell me, but you could.
It's $3.95 an hour and all I can eat.
Why did I think he'd answer that question? She told me how much she makes.
I'm sure she did.
fucking liar, isn't she? She's a liar.
I hope not. God bless her. She does.
I just want to stir it up. Just stir it up.
Stir it up.
Come on, I need a cigarette dangling out of my mouth. I think that would look good. It's like, I've seen this in films. It really works. You can talk about nothing and it really looks cool.
All right.
Live here. All right.
Okay, Ruby, break.
I think, all right. If this is as cool as it feels like, I think I'm cooking. What are we playing here? What is this? I've never played.
No, nothing. I was just dicking around.
All right, I'll break them. Hey, wait, I need chalk. I need to chalk up these vapes. Don't. You see, you thought I didn't know what I was doing. What do you just say? Just chalk up your end there. Watch this. Yeah, mama, I got the white. It means much more to get one in for guys than it does girls. Does that surprise you?
Well, yeah, well, it means one.
Okay, watch this. Why did I know you knew what you were doing? Yeah, Johnny. Look at how the eyes glaze over in manhood.
No, they're glasses. They really are. They're glazed,
no,
but professional.
John, over there.
Hey, what the?
Let's have another drink. Come on. Let's
cheers.
Cheers. Do you want to live here at all? Oh, look at us. Are we classy? You put the pinky up, you can cover for all the dribble you have down your front. Listen, I just wanted to ask you one question.
Yes?
I know this is weird, and I know you're exhausted, but there is a tea dance on the way home.
A tea dump?
A tea dance, where they danced with the harp playing.
Morris
music.
Dancing?
No, tea dancing, like foxtrotty kind of Englishy thing. The opposite of this. If I take you in a taxi on the way home, would you just stop off and do a little bit of a tea dance with me?
No. And it's because you're Jewish and a woman.
Get in there, John. We're going to that tea dance. Do you hate doing interviews? Because I saw you on Wogan and you were awful. It wasn't a good interview.
Well, he's a fabulous man and I'm sure he'll do well in his show.
He's over! He's finished in this country. Finished!
Well, he's a morning show.
I'm his replacement.
Now, doesn't
he? A morning show. If you don't buck up, I'm going to have a morning show.
where are we, boy?
The
bright
world.
Lights.
Where
you know how Americans react to bright things.
Get out there.
Hey, it's sparkly.
Can I just give you a little background? Because they won't care about this in America.
Nobody cares about anything. And they're never going to see it in America.
Well, we all die anyway, okay? We understand that premise, John. Can we just move on from there? I got a role in The Borrowers so that I could go up to John. It's a very I Love Lucy plot and say to him, would you be in my show?
Oh, Lucy, you're crazy.
Did I not do that, John?
Yeah.
Let's not admit that we wear glasses, okay, John? Because we really are as attractive as we seem.
Guys never.
Oh my God, it's John Goodman!
Guys never make passes at girls with fat ass or who wear glasses.
You've been working with a pretty big ass for 8 years. I keep stumm. Put your glasses on so you're not recognized.